Casey, give me five.
Yes.
Give me five. Give me five. Give me five. Give me five. Okay, your turn. Give me five. Okay.
Good.
Like this. Okay. Tell me, what's your name? What's your name? What's your name?
What's your name?
什么意思
？My name is Cassie. What's your name?
自我介绍。
Okay, ask me what's my name.
What's your name?
My name is Anna.
What's your name?
My name is 张小王子。
Okay. Casey.
Yes. Tell me,
how are you today?
I'm fine, thank you.
Okay. I'm fine, thank you.
How are you? 你能说中我吗？你能说中我吗？
I'm fine, thank you.
A little. How are you, Sue?
Casey, how are you today?
I'm good.
Okay, now ask me.
How are you, Anna?
I'm fine. How are you?
You are happy.
You can say, I'm fine.
Boy.
Okay.
I'm fine. I'm fine, thank you.
Thank you, 张小龙。
Oh, yeah, it's more difficult, yeah? Okay.
但是他全英语，没有一个汉字。我心里当时就想嘛，你为什么不用汉语，偏用英语？因为我不懂哎。
你的英语基础很差吗？
嗯，维宁。
你们那边是初一才开始学英语是吧？
对，七年级才开始学。
他开始学英语的时候，我看他的英语就相当于上海小朋友一年级的水平。我们这边如果小班就开始学英语的。上到一年级，他们已经可以和外教很流利的对话了。就是还有一个，这个小的学起来会比他更快一点。如果是小的在外教课堂上，外教老师说什么，他就跟着学。但是上初中以后的小朋友，他已经母语的思维已经在他脑子里面占到了绝对的一个领导地位。所以说，你再让他听全英文呢，他本身脑子里面是不错的。所以说，越小的学起来越容易。最佳的年龄是3岁到6岁的期间的。
从3岁开始，最小2岁半就开始学英语，相当于一个婴儿才出生，也就是个430天左右，就要接触英语这门外科，这对他来讲是一个完全不能适应的，所以我对这种行为表示抗议。